Good day, criminology students and reviewees. Today, we will discuss criminology as schools of thought. But before we tackle this topic, let me introduce to you first the brief history of criminology. So the history of criminology dates back from the works of criminological thinkers or theorists. The origins of criminology are usually located in the late 18th century writings of those who sought to reform criminal justice and penal systems that they perceived as cruel, inhumane, and arbitrary. These old systems applied the law unequally, were subject to great corruption, and often used torture and death penalty indiscriminately. Because of these practices, several schools of thought have developed that reform the early practices that others perceive as barbaric and unreliable explanations as to the causes of crime. And these approaches can be divided into three schools of thought, namely the classical, neoclassical, and positivist schools of thought. So let's go to classical school of criminology. Classical schools of thought, also known as the free will theory, that was advocated by Cesar Beccaria, who is regarded as the father of classical theory. This is considered as free will theory because classicists assume that people have free will to choose between good and evil. When we say free will, this is the ability of an individual to make decisions freely. That is why if a person committed an act which is considered crime, therefore he or she is liable or responsible to the consequences of his actions, regardless of the circumstances, whether that person is insane, whether that person is a child, whether that person has the mental disorder, they will be punished. Because this theory focuses only on the crime committed, not on the criminal itself. They use punishment to deter people from committing crime. And the purpose of penalty in the classical theory is retribution. When we say retribution, it is the act of vengeance or revenge. Next, let's go to arguments. In classical theory, there are four arguments used against classical theory. So first, it is unfair because it treats that all men as if they were robot without regard to the individual differences and the surrounding circumstances when the crime is committed. Second, it is unjust because they provide the same punishment for the first-time offender and recidivists. Recidivists, they are those persons who habitually convicted of crime. Third, the nature and definition of punishment is not individualized because the person of different classification who commit crimes suffer the same penalty. Last, it considers only the injury caused, not on the mental condition of the offender. So let's go to next, the neoclassical school of criminology. So the above criticism against the classical school led to the foundation of neoclassical school of criminology. This theory modified the doctrine of free will by stating that free will of men may be affected by other factors and crimes are committed due to some compelling reasons. These factors include pathology, incompetence, insanity, or any condition that will make it impossible for the individual to exercise free will and carbine. Because of this, it led to the proposition that while the classical doctrine is correct in general, but it should be modified that children and lunatics should not be regarded as criminals and free from punishment. It must take into the account of certain mitigating circumstances. Take note, one of the classic enforcements of neoclassical doctrine of criminology is the juvenile justice and welfare system recognizes that children cannot exercise free will and autonomy. As explained in one study, children have limited experiences and their capacities for judgment are still evolving. This theory has been adopted into the Philippine legal system either as exempting or mitigating circumstances, as can be gleaned under Article 12 and under Article 13 of the Revised Penal Code as amended. So next, let's go to positivist school. So positivist, also known as Italian theory, because it composed of Italians who agreed that in the study of crime, the emphasis should be on scientific treatment of the criminal. So the key idea behind this theory was the use of scientific method to understand criminality and crime. So the major differences between the two theories that the classical school is mainly based on free will and suggests that crime as a choice. Whereas positivist criminology argues that crime is not a choice because they believe that criminals are born as such and not made into criminals. In other words, it is the nature of the person, not nurture, that results in criminal propensities and believes that man is sick individual who needs treatment rather than punishment. Thus, instead of punishing these individuals, they believe that they should be corrected, reformed, and rehabilitated since their actions are caused by the outside factors such as poverty or economic factors. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.